monk and special integer. The first input is 4. That's the length of the array. And the next input is 8. We're going to call 8k. First, we've got to identify the sum of each subarray. Now, what are the subarrays? The subarrays of length 1 are 1, 2, 3, and 4, the elements themselves. So the sums are naturally going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what are the subarrays of length 2? They are all the consecutive elements of length 2. So here we can see 1 and 2 are consecutive adjacent elements. The sum of that will be 3. The next subarray of length 2 is 2, 3. Its sum will be 5. And the final subarray is 3, 4, and its sum will be 7. So the sum of all subarrays of size 2 is 3, 5, 7. Similarly, we've got to identify and calculate the sums of all subarrays of length 3. 1, 2, 3 is the first subarray of length 3. Its sum is going to be 6. And the next is 2, 3, 4, which has a sum of 9. The last subarray consists of every single element, 1, 2, 3, 4, and its sum is 10. The sum of all subarrays of size 1 are 1, 2, 3, 4. All of these numbers are less than 8. The sum of all subarrays of size 2, 3, 5, and 7. Again, all of these numbers are less than 8. But when we go to the third one, the sum of all subarrays of size 3 are 6 and 9. 9 is greater than 8, which is why this subarray is invalid. This means that the maximum valid subarray is of length 2, which is why our output is 2. Let's take an arbitrary input array. 2, 9, 1, 4, 3. Let's also say k equals 17. K is our threshold value. We're going to call these values a1, a2, a3, a4, and a5. The first thing we're going to do is calculate the sums. The first element in the new array is going to be 0. That makes calculating the sum easier. The next element is going to be 0 plus 2. That is 2. The next element will be 2 plus 9. That is 11. The next element will be 11 plus 1, that is 12, followed by 16 and 19. This array is going to be in strictly increasing order, and that's because the input array only has numbers that are greater than or equal to 1. So at least 1 will get added to each of these elements at each step. 2 is nothing but A1. 11 is A1 plus A2. 12 is A1 plus A2 plus A3. 16 is A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4. And 19 is A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus A5. I don't have space to write them, but you can imagine. How do we use this new array to calculate the subarrays, the sums of the subarrays? If we have to calculate every subarray of length 1, how do we do so? The first element will be A1. We know 2 is A1, so we subtract 2 from 0. That will be 2 minus 0, which is 2. How do we calculate A2? We know 11 is A1 plus A2, and we know 2 is A1. So to calculate A2, we have to subtract the element at index 2, that is A1 plus A2, and the element at index 1, that is A1. When we cancel them, we get A2, which is 9. 11 minus 2 gives us 9. How do we calculate every subarray of length 2? We know the first element will be A1 plus A2, that is 11 minus 0, which is 11. The next element will be A2 plus A3. How do we calculate that? This element, the element at position 3, is A1 plus A2 plus A3. And the element at position 1 is A1. We simply subtract those two to get A2 plus A3, that is 12 minus 2, which is 10. Now, how do we apply this knowledge that we have just learned? Well, you might have guessed that we're going to be using binary search. So we're first going to consider every subarray of length n by 2. Our starting index is going to point here. And the last index will point here. Li points to index 5, si points to index 1. So 5 plus 1 is 6, and 6 by 2 is 3. So mid is 3, the element at index 3. This means we're going to have to calculate every possible subarray of length 3. We've already discussed the first element in that subarray will be 12 minus 0, that is 12. The next element will be 16 minus 2, that is 14. And the final element will be 19 minus 11, that is 8. We know that k is 17, and each and every single one of these elements is less than 17. That means this is a valid subarray, which is why we move si to the next index. Now, mid is going to be 16. This is at index 4, so we've got to consider every subarray of length 4. There are only two elements of length 4, that's a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus a4, and a2 plus a3 plus a4 plus a5. Both of these values are less than or equal to 17, meaning they are both valid elements. Finally, we move si to the final location, that is 19. Here, we can straight away tell that 19 is greater than 17. That means this is a subarray of invalid length. Our result in this case will be 4. Remember, the first element is 0, and this loop is used to build that array. Now, if any single element in that array is greater than x, then we've got to print minus 1. That's because that means that we don't even have a subarray of length 1. Another boundary condition we've got to consider is if arr of n is less than x. This means that the final element a1 plus a2 plus a3 up until an is less than x. And this means that every single subarray is less than x. That's why we simply print n. Si is 1, li is n, and mid is si plus li by 2. First, we check every possible subarray of length mid. That's what this loop does. If even one element in that subarray is greater than x, it means that that entire subarray is invalid. So we've got to consider a smaller subarray. We move li to mid minus 1. If it manages to get through this entire while loop without ever hitting this break condition, then it is a valid subarray. So we move si to mid plus 1. That's because there may be a greater subarray that is also valid. Finally, si and li will both converge at the element that is just greater than x. So we print si minus 1 as a result. We can see that our samples have been passed. And once we hit submit, every test case has been accepted.